I don't think I ever consciously wanted to be an explorer. I didn't know what an explorer was. I just knew that I wanted to study fish.
When I am down and oh, my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, and I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me.
She was always looking at the best thing. She was a party girl. She never wanted to miss a thing. And same thing, even when we were around her, her hearing was bad, and we were talking, she'd be like, I can't hear you. What are you talking about? She just was always so curious. And her advice to people was, to children, was to follow your heart and take as much math as you can.
I've seen Jeannie sad or upset about things, but she always got out of it pretty quickly. And you know, I mean, she lived a long life and she faced a lot of adversity over the time. And she did, it did upset her, certain things did upset her. But I think the greatest thing about her was, she talked about it, the next time I see her, she's over it. She's onward and moving forward. So I think that her mental state was always one of optimism, happiness.
I read a lot of books, and I read about William Beebe, who was, of course, a great explorer. And I thought, wouldn't it be wonderful to go down the way William Beebe did? And my parents would say, well, maybe you can study typing and how to be a good secretary, and you can become a secretary to somebody like William Beebe. That would be exciting, wouldn't it? And I said, no, I don't want to be anybody's secretary. I want to do that stuff myself. I want to be like William Beebe.
You raise me up so I can't stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
We first met in graduate school at NYU. She and I were both PhD students, and we shared some classes together, and we shared a mentor. Dr. Charles Breeder was our mentor. She was a good friend and a precious friend, and she's a great loss. And her loss is her remarkable charisma and her sparkling personality and her absolute devotion to science. She was an ardent scientist and a true scientist.
As a student, I met Dr. Eugenie Clark, and she was just so receptive, not the least bit off-putting and saying, oh, here's this kid who is, I could be regarded as a nuisance, but she really sort of adopted me as a friend, truly more of a friend than anything else, and sort of tucked me under her flipper here in the Sarasota area, took me diving with her. We went on a mini expedition down to the Florida Keys in the 1950s. It really made a difference to me.
And this man, Bill Mote, came to my office and he said, you know, I really admire the work that your laboratory does. And I've always been interested in the sea, and it's wonderful to come here and be able to see all the books and information that you're gathering about the sea. We'd like to build a laboratory, something like yours, maybe a little further north, but we don't want to interfere with your laboratory. And tell us how we should go about it. So I said, well, why don't you offer to take over this lab? Because the Vanderbilts don't live here anymore. And he lived in St. Petersburg, and then he moved to Sarasota. So he started helping us with the lab and taking us out in his big boat that was bigger than the lab. And it's just started to grow from this little 8x10 room to what it is today.
You raise me up so I can't stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more.
Jeannie was the kind of person that if you went into her office and spent 5 minutes talking to her, your day was going to be better. It just was, because she brought such a lightness of being to the world's problems. She was so focused on research and on understanding nature, understanding the world. She didn't get involved in a lot of politics. She didn't care about administration. She just was like a child still discovering the natural world. And just to touch that each day was a treasure for us.
Not even a year ago, Jeannie and I celebrated her 92nd birthday diving in the Gulf of Aqaba off the Red Sea. At 92 years old, this scientist, this trailblazer, was still extremely active in conducting research at her old research sites and some of my research sites that I followed on a generation later. And the people there still remember Jeannie from the days when she conducted research there. And the moment we both went underwater together in the Gulf of Aqaba, this woman became a ballerina. She was so at ease. She was in her element when we were underwater. And the observations as we swam along the bottom, and everyone, of course, was focused on Jeannie. Jeannie was focused on the environment around her, and she observed two little leafy fish, camouflaged fish, that nobody else could see. And Jeannie picked them out and pointed them out to the rest of us. So still at 92 years old, active, passionate, and producing scientific publications literally until the day she left our blue planet. She will always leave here at Mote the passion that she had for science, the inspiration that we continue to have today based on her life. And this institution is truly her lasting legacy here on Earth.
We are not closely affiliated. We're still independent. We can do what we want to do, our studies. And we have a lot of freedom and interesting things we can take on without all the bureaucracy of a big university. So it's very nice for young people today to have a chance to apply to a place like this. And it's very nice that places like this can support some of these students. I wish there was more support for them, but I think people are starting to appreciate men and women, young men and women, getting into this field.
And as family and friends, we gather here this day and therefore commit the earthly remains of our beloved Eugenie Clark to the deep, looking for the general resurrection in the last day and for the life of the world to come through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Love you, Grandma Jeannie.
Do you want me to do all or do you
yeah,
want
no,
to do
go,
some?
Go ahead.
Goodbye, Mama. We love you. Back
your
to
last
the ocean.
Dive. No gear needed.
More than I.